Alad, in the summer of 2020, CMHC released a fairly pessimistic forecast with respect to Canada's housing market, suggesting we would see a 9 to 18% decrease in home prices over the next 12 months. It's been booming, if not overheating, if you will. What is happening now? What is your forecast?
So in the short term, we're going to see continued growth, as we've been seeing in the last few months. What seems to have been happened is that the particularly higher income households have been able to cope with COVID restrictions in the workplace. There's been a lot of innovation through work from home, through technology such as Zoom. And so a lot of higher income households have been able to retain their income. At the same time, they're obviously spending less money on restaurants, on travel, on all sorts of activities. But this is also combining with the desire for more living space. The working from home, it seems to be a little bit difficult if you're in a cramped environment. And so all of this seems to have driven a strong demand for housing, particularly single detached housing, particularly maybe more suburban, maybe more rural, and that is driving a trend. A weak spot or an area that we don't know as much about is the rental sector. So obviously a lot of lower income households, maybe working in bars, restaurants, and hotels have been very adversely affected by the economic restrictions. And so there's a little bit of concern about what is going on in the rental sector.
Indulge us here for a moment. Help me understand why there is such a disparity when it comes to forecasts across the board. CMHC, CREA, TREB, the banks, the real estate companies. Why is the forecast so varied across the board?
Oh, that's a tough one to call. I think the approaches are generally similar, but there are a lot of important differences. I think there are differences in the way the data are presented. So for example, last year with CMHC's forecast, we presented the data as an extreme case, sort of a peak to trough in the technical jargon. It was an extreme case. But that was taken as more of a what we were predicting on average. So there are questions on how things are interpreted. I think at CMHC, we try to take a longer view. In particular, we have much stronger links between our forecasts and the economy, the macro economy. And so last year, we tied our housing forecast very strongly to economic projections. What we didn't understand at the time was that the macro economy would be two different camps, two different groups within the macro economy, lower, which in the jargon has been abbreviated as a K-shaped economy. So you have higher income households doing relatively well and lower income households obviously struggling. So I think this is an important distinction, and I think that's why we're trying to tie our forecast very much more strongly to economic projections rather than just continuing momentum from the recent past.
Do you think a correction is on the way?
Well, it's always very difficult to do those sorts of short-term predictions. We are seeing heightened risks in the market. Some of those would include, for example, a very low level of listings at the moment. Perhaps people are unwilling to invite people to see their homes and put them up for sale. So the level of listings is very low, and that could expand. We're still very uncertain about whether this movement to the suburbs, to rural communities is permanent. We don't know how businesses will react in the medium to longer term with work from home. Maybe households will need to show up for work once or twice a day, once or twice a week. As a result, maybe there'll be this movement towards the suburbs and rural communities may have gone too far. So those are sort of immediate risks relevant to the housing market. Going forward on a more macro scale, we're still not sure about the path of the pandemic. How will the economy recover as the pandemic eventually dissipates? And all along this process, there's a heightened level of government debt, of public debt, of debt held by households. But, well, to be fair, also government debt, and how all of this will be resolved is not clear at the moment.
You mentioned listings on the market. Let's talk about the supply side. And are we building the relevant infrastructure? What needs to happen on the supply side?
On the supply side, I think there are issues within the resale market. And so you have listings that are very low at the moment. And so people there's not a lot of houses in the resale market for sale. The focus for CMHC has been on the longer term structural undersupply of housing, of new housing, of new construction. That's where there needs to be concerted action by all levels of government. These characteristics of housing prices going up and down, of being volatile, this is all emblematic of not enough housing, of not enough supply. So you asked a question about infrastructure. I think there's a lot of infrastructure associated with housing. Housing to some is a form of infrastructure as well. And there needs to be more of this type of infrastructure, more housing, more infrastructure. Some types of infrastructure would include more water and sewerage to enable more housing to be built. But there are obviously more difficult areas, such as with electrification of vehicles. Are we going to need as much highway infrastructure? So there's a lot of dilemmas here, but I think it's clear that we need more housing supply, more new construction.
Do you think the government needs to step in at this point?
Well, it's difficult to call. As I described earlier, there are lots of moving parts at the moment, and we still don't know what is going on with those movements. Our business is going to require workers to show up for work physically in their old location. Is work from home going to become more widespread? At the moment, I think everybody's trying to react and understand these trends. So as the market tries to figure out what's going on, maybe it's a bit premature at the moment to have significant more policy action. By the same token, obviously at CMHC, we're very concerned about debt levels, and we're continuing to monitor the situation, particularly as the pandemic unfolds and hopefully comes to an end. There's a lot of people that are either underemployed or not employed, particularly younger people, particularly lower income households. And so I think it's important for employment to recover fully before taking significant action.
The Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem recently said that it's not the time to tighten rules, even though they do see an excess exuberance in the housing market. When should the Bank of Canada step in?
Well, obviously that's a decision for the Bank of Canada. But to be fair, the concerns are there, but I think they have to balance a number of risks. And at the moment, it seems to me that the risks are for what is happening with lower income households and the employment recovery. It's possible that the recovery from the pandemic will be relatively fast. There's a lot of savings at the moment. People aren't able to go to restaurants, etc. So maybe a lot of these savings will go immediately back into the economy and there will be a resurgence in employment. But we honestly don't know. So I think we're going to have to see in particular how the employment path recovers with the pandemic.